In this video, we'll compare Nginx with HA Proxy and Traffic using latest available versions at this time. We'll measure latency from the client side using P90 percentile, as well as evaluate how many requests per second each proxy can handle, CPU usage of the proxies, CPU usage of the applications behind those proxies, and finally availability or error rate. I use AdBS to run all my tests, and I used M7A large EC2 instance for each proxy as well as for each application. Each VM has 2 CPUs and 8 GB of memories. I also use EKS cluster to run my monitoring components such as Prometheus, Grafana and others, and I deploy clients that generate load in that cluster using Kubernetes jobs. Each proxy uses a TLS certificate for HTTPS, and we use HTTP2 protocol between clients and proxies, and HTTP1.1 protocol between proxies and backend applications. Additionally, each VM has a node exporter, and I instrumented my clients with Prometheus metrics to measure latency and throughput. You can find configuration files in my public GitHub repository. This is not the first time I've used Nginx, so I have optimized it very well for this test based on the previous feedback I've received over time. Also, Nginx does not use keep alive with backends by default, so you need to explicitly enable it using keep alive directive as well as some headers. For HA proxy, I used bare minimum and mostly default settings. I have a TLS certificate, and I also use 2 servers for the backend. Finally, we have traffic and pretty much the same settings. And I disabled access logs for every single proxy, just for the benchmark. If you want to reproduce this benchmark, you can follow my full EKS course here on YouTube and use the tests from my GitHub repository. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. The entire test took around 2.5 hours, and I compressed it to just a couple of minutes. During the test, you'll see that one proxy fails pretty quickly, and I remove it from the dashboard until the end of the test. Let me run this test for one more minute. And I'll go over each graph one by one at the end of the test. Alright, first we have throughput. To be honest, I didn't expect that HA proxy would perform much better than Nginx. Traffic only reached 22,000 requests per second, Nginx around 37,000 requests per second, which is the same level as in all my previous benchmarks, and HA proxy reached 76,000, which is a new record for the proxies. Well, maybe except for the Pingora, which is more of a library than a standalone proxy. Next, we have latency. In this case, HA proxy again performed much better than any other proxies. Lower latency is always better, as it means a better user experience. For example, a web page would load faster for the user. Then we have CPU usage. Nginx with TLS enabled fails at around 80%, and it's not related to open file descriptors. It's very consistent behavior that I've noticed in many other tests, but only when I enable TLS on Nginx. Without TLS, it performs much better. Next, we have CPU usage of the applications behind these proxies. You might notice a similar pattern. When a proxy starts to degrade, it forwards less traffic to the backend applications. Next, we have availability, or simply the error rate. This is the ratio between successful requests with status codes 200 and 300 and failed requests with 400 and higher. Finally, we have network transmit traffic. This is measured in both directions, toward the client as well as toward the applications. So proxies might have slightly different default settings and compression levels. Well, I didn't expect that HA proxy would outperform Nginx. In real world, I don't really use standalone reverse proxies. Instead, I use ingress controllers based on these proxies. So in one of my next videos, I'll be testing Nginx ingress controller versus HA proxy ingress controller. For now, you can take a look at my other benchmarks comparing different databases, caches, and even languages.